just let me know. Okay, so I'm considering that every one of you can see. So I'm not on the hangout right now, so I can't see any comments, but I'll keep on revisiting at regular intervals. So we definitely started with this initial slides, but I'll take a brief overview that you, in your internal assessment, you're supposed to do two things. One is individual investigation, which is marked, and it is 20% of your overall 100% grade. And one is group four project, which is unmarked. So it depends on school, how they want to conduct group four project. And it's a subject or it's a topic that we can discuss all together separately. We also introduce group four project to our school, and we do it together after the first year. So between IB1 and IB2, we do group four project when their first and end of year exams are done. Now, individual investigations, I said errors are very important. So even if you don't have errors in the experiment, give justification, because without error, an experiment is like, even a master level project has error in their experiment. So think why you didn't have error in your experiment. Now, general guidelines were given that you will be given 10 hours of your class time to conduct an experiment, discuss with your teacher. But this 10 hours does not mean that you are supposed to give your final report within this 10 hours. You can write your report, you can do your processing of the data outside the school at your home and everything. So I won't take much time in this. We also went through AIIMS. I want you to read the AIIMS once so that you come to know what IB is expecting from you and what examiners are expecting from you. So 21st century skills, as I said. So when I say 21st century skill, use of technology, how effectively you showcase or write your report is important. So you will be judged on this particular components: personal engagement, exploration, analysis, evaluation, and communication. Personal engagement carries 2 marks and it is holistically marked. You don't need to write a paragraph on personal engagement. That is not only going to give you mark. So we are going to discuss in the end. I'm going to take you through what are the important do's and don'ts for each of the criteria. So right now you just remember that anything above 21 is going to give you 7. 21 or above 21 gives you 7. So personal engagement and communication are two places wherein you should never ever lose marks. If you keep few things in mind, which I'm going to tell you at a later stage, you will never ever lose these marks. And exploration also, it's in your hands. You can never lose marks. The only place where you can lose mark is analysis. So I'll tell you the various 5 important steps that you should do when you're doing analysis. Now, as I said, there are various types of experiments that you can do. A simple laboratory experiment in your school or outside school environment is allowed. You can simply use a spreadsheet or a Microsoft Excel to analyze data and model something. So I'm going to take you through an example of secondary data analysis as well. Now, sometimes when you visit CERN website or any big website, .org or .edu, they have millions and millions of data. I have 1 terabyte of data of CERN collision. So I can't use entire data to analyze. So I'll extract some bit of that data and analyze that data graphically. Now those data will have to be analyzed graphically after doing certain data processing. Sometimes you can use spreadsheet, database work, and you can combine it with hands-on experiment or simulation. Now, you will always come across an experiment. Sometimes there are rare chances that you find out an experiment or you like a topic wherein there is a lot of qualitative analysis and there is no quantitative evidence. So such kind of experiments are also allowed, but keep this thing in mind. You need to show some kind of data of that qualitative work. So I don't think many of you will end up here, but if you end up here, let me know. I can definitely take a session with you, or we can discuss over email how to go about with these guidelines. Now, as I said, brainstorming is very important. Then frame an RQ. Once your RQ is framed, everything is in place. So I'm going to take you through the process again. So mind map, developing a mind map is very much important. Do it. If you don't want to do it on laptop, just use your pen and paper and at least jot down some points, because it will definitely take you through your interest. Sometimes we feel that there is no use drawing mind map. I like this particular topic, but at least try, and then you will come to know how your muscle memory works, and it helps your subconscious mind to take out things from your brain. So this is important phase wherein we are introducing the IS to you. Then you're going to select a topic of interest. So if you have 12 topics in your subject, you can select any one topic that you are interested in. Then you select a subtopic. Then you research about that subtopic and what are the various parameters that you can particularly experiment on. Also, you should once go to your lab and see what all sensors and what all equipments you have. So you get a general idea of how you are going to design your experiment. Then comes selection of independent and dependent variables. Independent variable is a variable which you are changing through the experiment. And dependent variable is a variable that you are going to measure after changing the independent variable. Frame a proper focused research question. There is no hard and fast rule that there should be one independent variable and one dependent variable. But if your supervisor is saying you that one independent variable and one dependent variable is sufficient for your IA, then listen to them because they are experienced and they know that you are going to get sufficient quantitative data to analyze on that particular parameters. So when I was saying you were doing some qualitative analysis, you had only some data like time period of a pendulum. The data generated is very less. In such circumstances, you should definitely choose one more independent variable so you have more data to play with it. Then gather feedback and confirmation from your supervisor. Once you have a confirmation, then you do certain background research and find out the list of variables that you can control or would be needed in your experiment. Design your own experiment. Even if you have a direct experiment, now see, nowadays examiners are told to use Google or any online media to check whether the same experiment, the same type of experiment is available on the net. If I am going through some experiment in IA and if I feel I have seen this IA somewhere, then I can search it and I come to know, oh, this is similar, only you have changed the words. Then those things are also being taken into care from this year. So try to design or modify that experiment. So I'm going to give you a very good example today on how an experiment which was very traditional in that era, using 21st century skills, it becomes very much easier. And then comes your test, data collection and processing. So this is my mind map which I show to my students and it's in my lab also. I place it everywhere for EE also and everything. So I have such kind of mind maps for each and every internal assessments. So we framed research question last time. We went through this particular activity, so I would not waste time doing that. Now, you have phone and technology right now. You can use many apps. I'm going to take you through one particular app today. So first, I'll show you an interesting math hi, and then we'll go to that particular app. So this was the IA done by one of my students. And the most interesting part is this IA did not get 7, it got 6. Because of his error which he made, but modeling the perfect eyes is the topic of Max HL. So what he wanted to do, the beauty parameter of individual faces. So if you're looking at the shape of your face, if your eyes are placed in a perfect, so we modeled a perfect equation of eye. If we use that equation, any face can be made very much attractive. So plastic surgeons usually, see, nobody is doing this for eye, but this was his area of interest. And therefore, how do we do this experiment? We took 50 samples or 25 samples of good-looking people as per the child. Or he also went to Forbes magazine and he found out 25 best good-looking people in the world and took their eye image. And we set the origin at their central point. So it's the center of the eyebrow region. And then we traced this. This is known as photo analysis. So you might have heard you can do video analysis, but you can also do photo analysis. If you have certain photo of a bridge or photo of certain other particular area of interest, you can always do photo analysis of that particular picture as well. So in ESS, not ESS, in math studies, people used to do photo analysis of Taj Mahal, photo analysis of Eiffel Tower. So any kind of photos can be done. So if you have any questions, you can always ask me. I'll let you know how photo analysis has to be done. this student used Desmos. So we have elliptical symmetry. In an ellipse, you have two points of eccentricity. He used those eccentricity and tried to judge the equation. So this was for Hugh Jackman. Then similarly, he found out some, he did background research and he came to know there is something known as torus, and the equation of torus matches this equation. So I won't take you through this eye, but I'm going to share this eye with you so that you get a general idea how this eye was done. So it's a math eye, but a very interesting eye because he was loving. Now this is a sample which he showed. So in your eye, you're not supposed to show each and everything that you're doing. Just a sample of what you did is sufficient, and rest everything comes in the appendix. So these are the people that he used. And he found out A and D ratio and see how close they are. Now it also depends on the face size, which he kept controlled. He said, I am not judging, or I'm not going to study the face size. We can always include the size of the shape whenever we want to do this equation. That has been written in the further investigation. So this is the modeled equation that you need to use if you want a beautiful face. And this is his own eye. And he tried to say how much is the percentage error between a good beautiful eye and his shape of the eye. So he found out the error of 6%, that his eyes needs to be at this dotted region to make it more beautiful. So this is the appendix wherein he has shown everything. So simple use of Desmos to get this result. Okay. I hope you find this thing interesting. Before going through, this is an app available on Android as well as iPhone. So what happens is this is known as Firefox. There are several other apps, but I am using this app because it has got a specific feature and it is authentic. They particularly have a website. You can contact them. They'll send you the lab manual, or else most of the information is present itself on the website, and it is .org website. You don't need to find lab manual and anything. Just citing this particular website will give you full marks, like full marks for the citation. This is non-plagiarized site because .org, .edu, .gov, .gov, they all are considered to be authentic. And see how many sensors they are allowing you to use. You can do experiments on Doppler effect, proximity, stopwatch. So I'll just show you a 1 minute video of this particular people. And this is the website. There are many experiments. This is very new website, so hardly any students are using this. So I would suggest few of you to go through these experiments and use this app. This is in this lockdown period, you can use this to your maximum.
Smartphones have become a part of our everyday life. But did you know that using the right apps, they turn into small labs ready to discover the world of physics? A simple example: put your phone into a paper roll and track its velocity with our FIFOX app, live and wireless. Everybody uses elevators, but did you ever wonder how fast elevators are? Let's find out.
So this is an interesting experiment a physics person can do as well as a bio person can do. The speed of elevator and rise or decrease in your blood pressure or heartbeat rate, you can monitor that. See, nobody, I don't know whether heartbeat is going to change with the speed of elevator or no. So you can simply judge, do that experiment. And in the end, even if there is no effect, you will get marks because you did an experiment which was very much valid.
It's possible thanks to the smartphone's barometer measuring atmospheric pressure. Just one of the many sensors you are carrying right inside your pocket. Track pendulum movement, analyze magnetic fields, or even the spectrum of audio signals. Turn your smartphone into a physics lab with our FIFOX app. Discover the world of physics.
But they are very much inclined to physics. But as you know, as I give you example, you can always club it with your sciences. It's just you need to think. Just think and you will definitely get many ideas. So light sensor, when you are giving light to a plant, you can use this particular sensor. You can do experiment at your home also. So there are certain experiments wherein you will have to wait for 24 hours to get reading. You know, you can't be in the school environment to do that. You can set up an experiment in your home. If you have a spare phone, you can just keep your phone there and go. Data will be connected live. And the best part is your phone and your laptop get synced. You can sync them both, and live readings can be taken as he did. He kept the phone inside that roller, and reading was taken on the laptop. So think of this app. I would suggest visit this website. It's simple, phyphox.org. Now, I'm going to take you through five examples, five physics IA, and just see what all things they have done so that you get a general idea of how IA has to be done, how it has to be written, or how my students have been writing, what is my guidance. Definitely use your teacher's guidance, because this is my work. Your teacher might have some interesting ideas to give in, so you can always mix and match those ideas. So let's go through various IA. So this is the first IA wherein this student is from Brazil. What he did is he wanted to study the convex lens and the ray diagram. Now this is very basic experiment, but what makes it more interesting is he's a scuba diver. He dived in Brazil, he dived in India. So we went for a scuba diving trip together in our CAS project. He came up with a question that due to salinity, he has a very high number of glasses. So he thought that I'm not able to see objects very much clearly. And while scuba diving, he was not allowed to wear glasses. So how does the salinity affect, like salinity in the water level affect the perception? So we tried to research so much, but we did not find any experiment till date done on this. So now this was a very new experiment for him to do. So what he did is, the simple thing is how the focal length of an image changes with the salinity of water. We could have done this in our lab, but since his personal engagement or his idea of research was with respect to scuba diving and everything, we had to find out how do we make samples which match the salinity of the seawater. So we went through website, and basically there was a research found out by official National Institute of Oceanography, which tells you that 3.5% of the entire volume of the water is salt. So if I take 1000 ml of water right now and I replace it by 3.5% of salt, now I have conditions which are equivalent to normal sea. Definitely I'm ignoring other minerals which are present, but definitely I have something to research. This is equivalent to my seawater. So this was an interesting finding by the student, which tells you the curiosity level of the student. So this adds to the personal engagement. So there were many other stuff. You can read this, I'll share with you. So this was basic optical bench experiment that you do for a convex lens to find out the focal length. So there is a light, you move the convex lens, and until and unless you get a focused image, you keep on adjusting this stuff. But now imagine he had to do this entire thing inside saline water. Now how are we going to move stuff inside the water? And water, if water displaces, the entire reading changes. So you had to do this thing in a still water. So there were, if you read his things, he'll come to know how much trouble he had to face. The first trouble, we do not have dark room in our lab. So he had to create a dark environment. So he went to the event head, which is definitely again me, because I'm the CAS coordinator. So we had black curtains in the school environment. So we gave him section of a lab. He completely blacked out that particular section. Now the second question was using this particular beam. So when we placed, we found out a cubical container wherein we could fill the salt water and insert this convex lens inside this. So right now I am in a scuba diving position. My eye is inside the water. Now the only thing is I have a beam of light which is not that strong to produce an image outside. So this was the second difficulty. Student has mentioned this difficulty inside the paper. So he had to go and find many lights of higher frequency, and then we got an image. Now how do we record this image? So we used a graph paper here. So he came up with a shape, because if you have a single image, it is going to be blurred. So we came up to a shape like this, and we had to cut a slit through it. So this is the dark room. So this is the image that you used to get, not a sharp image, but still good to do an experiment. So I have an error in my experiment. So you could see it's a basic setup, no hardened, a wooden block, a lens is kept like this, a graph paper on a cardboard, a simple lamp. Now we had to connect this particular cardboard because light was spreading, you know, dispersion of light. So therefore he had to come up with this slit idea. And this entire experiment, and see, we gave him a table wherein we could actually draw things. So he is showing you this is object distance, this is image distance. A simple lens rule from IGCSE is used in IB physics experiment. And see what he is doing. He has several samples, several beaker, and see, it does not look good, but still it's an experiment which is working. So this has been given the authenticity and marks will be, credit was given to the student for this. He still lost one mark because of this. You can't read this thing. So this is, I think this is not the final report. I had given a feedback to change this. So there's one mistake in errors and uncertainties, but still okay, he gets a 7 in this. So various trials were taken for the mass of the water. This is how he presented his report. See the number of significant figures. So can you guess one error? This is the first draft, I am sure. So one error is, see, everything is represented up to one decimal point, but this 42 and this 40 is not done properly. And when I ask my student, your significant figures are not matching. I'm not supposed to directly tell him, oh, this is not correct. This is just 8, this is not 8.0. He figured out himself and he came to me and he told that I did this particular bit in spreadsheet, and in spreadsheet 8.0 automatically turns into 8. Now this is a problem wherein he had to import his entire diagram, just type 8.0 into Word and then take a screenshot so that he does not face the same difficulty. So in final report, everything is corrected. But I think I have purposely chosen this so that I can show you various errors that are made in this. So 42.0 and 40.0. So it should be consistent with your list count. Now here, on this particular part, marks won't be deducted because it's an independent variable. Still, I would recommend write it as 0.0, 1.0. You are going to be examined on this particular bit. And this is the graph which I prefer students should draw it like this. If you use Logger Pro, you get this all information directly. You don't have to do anything else. Whether you do it manually or it generates automatically, an examiner will have to give you credit because you have spent time drawing this graph. So I'm going to do an activity with you. Like I'll draw and I'll show you how line of maxima and minima has to be done on a graph paper. So since we have only 1 hour, so I'm going to take you through this very fast. Otherwise, I could have explained you this into more detail. And this is done. So I'll just close this for now. Now, this is the second IA, which was done in 2017. This was again based on salinity and temperature of seawater affecting the surface tension of the seawater. So this guy used to work in, like his uncle used to be a commander of a ship, and he went for a party and he came with an interesting idea that will sonar get affected due to the salinity of seawater, and he did an experiment. The only flaw in this experiment is he used too much of background information. But the best part about this experiment is his design. Now see, the actual apparatus used to measure the surface tension in any liquid is this Dewey-Noy ring method. So what happens if this is very precise and very smooth with various gears and there is a ring here. So what happens is when you insert a ring inside the solution, you need to remove it very slowly. The moment it comes out, you have to take readings. The moment it comes out. So you will have to go through this thing. So this was a simple design, but it is a very precise. So what this student came did is, now look at his design. He has a force sensor. He used a simple small ring. He had a small diameter ring, or you can have a copper wire and you make your own ring. And he connected to a thread. Now this entire experiment using the sensor gives you the same reading as this particular apparatus. Now getting this apparatus would have cost us so much So we could not buy this, so he came up with this particular experiment. So this is known as using 21st century skills. So you can, it's okay, you will have so many errors in this experiment, but what you are getting is surface tension. He wanted to measure surface tension, and this is the only method available to measure the surface tension using this. So he had different salt solution, and the force sensor gave different readings for each of the solution the moment he removed out. Now the only error in this was the force given by his hand. So he made sure that the hand was at the same level and he was using the same force, but he's justifying that sometimes there might be an error, but the pulling force is given by this force sensor. So he explains what Dunoyer ring method is and what he is basically doing. So he used a platinum ring because there was a reason. But the major mistake made by this student was in his data collection. So this is the format that he has presented, which was, I am not happy with his format. And there were too many graphs, unnecessary graphs. So he thought that in analysis, if you give too much graph, you get marks. But this was not necessary. He could have kept few graphs in the appendix. But still, he is losing still only 3 marks. So it brings him to 21, which is still a 7. Now, this is, I consider this is one of the good work that we have done so far. Because this student wanted to use 2 independent variables. One is tension and one is radius, and find out its effect on the tangential velocity. So it's a simple circular motion experiment. So he is not from India. He was staying abroad. He came to India for studying because they are diplomats. So he came up with this idea of this particular ride, and we linked it to this particular simple experiment. So I told him that before doing experiment, just use an app and try to find out. So he had to frame an hypothesis. To frame an hypothesis, always use an app or any pilot reading so that you get an idea that what are you expecting. And accordingly, you can design your experiment. So this is a pen cap, empty pen without the refill. Then he connected a rubber cork, paper clip, and a hanging mass. And he was rotating this thing. So it's a normal uniform circular motion. He wanted to use a motor here, but keeping a motor constant was not happening. How do you keep motor moving in a horizontal motion? If you have motor, then you have to connect this tube here and then it keeps moving. So he wanted to keep very simple. So he came up with this experiment. Now this kind of experiment is available on internet, but if you check the experiment, he has used his brain. So those people use crocodile clip, but he uses paper clip because in his experiment, crocodile clip was tearing away the string. So those people were using thread. This guy is using a plastic string which does not expand on giving tension to it. So this was one of the interesting thing which he came up with, was the material of the string was something that needed to be chosen carefully, as most materials such as threads, cotton and rubber extend when force is applied to them. You know Young's modulus, simple thing. When you apply a force, it expands and then it comes back. So it was the elasticity thing which popped in his mind because we were doing that lesson. So he chose to use a nylon string which requires lots and lots of tension to expand. So you understand, this is the personal interest and design which will give him more marks in exploration and personal engagement. So I like the way this eye is presented, keeping in mind all the significant figures. The only thing that he could have done here is this 0.01 is constant throughout the readings. You can put it in the heading and it simplifies. So rather than putting it everywhere, you can have kept it in the main heading. But it's not wrong doing this also. But after 2 years, and this is the presentation of data. His data collection was too much because he was varying 3 different quantities and measuring output. So to make it simple for the examiner, what he did, he highlighted this part. So in this particular blue part, I am measuring this and this. In this particular part, this is my independent, this is my dependent. This is my independent, this is my dependent. Now this is communication skills. And I'll keep this here for 10 seconds so that you can just see this, how this is presented. You can have your own innovative ideas of presenting, but number significant figures. And this is data collection. This much section which is not shown in the paper, and this is the process data. So what we ideally show is process data table. No need of showing raw data table. So he could color club both of them together, so it's fine. Now there is entire another method of finding uncertainties. I hope you know theory how to find uncertainty in a formula. So this is the formula to find uncertainty calculation. So I hope you know how to find out uncertainty using any formula. There are three different principles that you need to use. So if it is F is equal to MA, if I want to find uncertainty in this, it's delta F over F, which is equal to mass is constant, so it is ignored. So delta F upon F is equal to delta A upon A. So delta F will be equal to F times the entire product. So I'm going to share notes of uncertainties with you. If you want me to do a session on uncertainty, let me know, or even your physics teacher can do this part. It's quite okay. Now this guy has lost one mark in his IA because again, too many graphs. These three graphs were not necessary. This was very much okay. If he would have showcased only these four graphs, it was done. But why to show extra things? Just to fill 12 pages. So this was his mindset that no, my IA should be of 12 pages. It's okay if your IA ends in 8 pages. It was very nice work done by the student. But still, you lose a mark because of that. And this is the percentage difference, evaluation and everything. So I'll tell you what all things are needed in evaluation, what all things are needed in analysis. So basically, conclusion is what is the result of your experiment. Analysis is all the graphical things that you are doing, finding percentage difference and everything. Evaluation is what better things you could have done in this experiment. What are your future investigation that can be done with this? What were the sources of errors and suggestions for improvement? This is fine for evaluation. Now, this is another experiment. It is about parachute. Now, making a parachute is very simple. It's an aerodynamic thing. People usually get confused. This experiment was done in school itself. So you take a garbage bag and knot it down at several points, connect the string and connect it to a rubber cork or anything. So this was the idea used by the student. So I'll show you the image that he has done of his experiment. So this is the background research. Now see this. So he had a load connected to a garbage bag with strings. He kept a height constant. Now to find out the air resistance, we need a very huge height. So from that height, this was released and readings were taken. So when he started, when he released, timer was turned on, and when it went down, timer was turned off. So a simple experiment. Now he lost one mark because he revealed himself here. Now this is going to be taken seriously now onward. Now here I can't see, even if I zoom, I can't see his face clearly. So it was better. Otherwise this goes directly into academic dishonesty, because this is my previous school. You can see the uniform. You can just trace it back to the school. So this is not allowed to reveal yourself. But what he was trying to show is how high reached a maximum height and how I kept this height constant. And it was released from that particular height. Now see, the best part, one of the important things that I wanted to tell you, can you see the nature of the graph? You can't draw any curve here. Even if I want to draw a line, I can't, like, it's not giving me any nature. So this experiment basically did not give me any result. But student is mentioning I did this much. I think this is the problem. This is the source of error. And otherwise I should have got the conclusion which matched my hypothesis. But there is definitely something wrong. And later on, I came to know there is vibrational motion. Then there was a release point was not same. Then starting and turning off of stopwatch, I should have used light gates. But I don't have light gates that long to take readings. So it was justified. And this IA scored 23 marks. Now see, he is not getting result. But work is done, justification is given. So if he would have thought this thing in the beginning, he would have got the result as well. That is why brainstorming is very much necessary. So when I was doing this, I was also new to IB, he was also new. So I never did that brainstorming. I directly started with an experiment. So that's the reason I'm saying brainstorming and mind map is necessary. And this is the IB score, 18 marks, which is grade 6. And see how simple this experiment is. Now the research question sounds very much difficult. Investigating the increase in temperature of different colored fabrics after exposure to light for a given interval of time. Now this same thing can be done with plants, okay? Take the same eye, do it with plants. It is going to give you some different readings, I am telling you. And it can be done with different chemicals also, wherein you want to study the photosensitivity of that particular chemicals. Now see, I'll directly take you through the experiment. Now, these are the five different cloth materials that the student used. So this was the preliminary test. So you get those friendship bands, the satin ribbons, and he and she exposed this particular thing to a light for 1 hour. And then the she simply touched this fabric and felt which one is more hot. So this was her the preliminary test, which would always give you marks. And this is the setup. 6 bulbs, tripod stands, and thermometers were connected here like this below the fabric, and fabric was just kept on the top. So she maintained the height, and you turn on the lamp for 1 hour or 2 hours, and later on you just come and measure the temperature. Obviously, each and every cloth has a rate of absorption. So this is what her experiment was about, rate of absorption of light. So you could see that black gave maximum increase in temperature. See, the rise in temperature, the change was variation is in the last decimal place. It won't give you significant change. If you want a significant change, the exposure time should be long, the cloth should be thick, but see, simple eye. But it gave marks. The only thing, you can directly make out what is the error here. There is no trace of uncertainty here. Thermometer is an analog instrument. It has an uncertainty which is not stated. In spite of giving the feedback in the first draft, student did not make any changes. I could not do anything else. So you definitely lose 2 marks there. And this is the graph. Graph has been plotted, but there is no analysis to the graph. I can't see any particular analysis done. It's a simple theory writing which is given to me. So you understand where the maximum marks are lost. So see, but how simple the experiment was. Now this is an experiment of rotating platform. I can't show. Okay, I'll have to. So this is the simple experiment done by the student, wherein he is trying to find out the rotating platform. So he created a rotating hotel experiment, and uniform circular motion was explored like this. You can see the error in this experiment, that crocodile clip is here. Actually, it is here. So, but the experiment is very much good. So this is how you investigate. See the presentation. Process data table, percentage difference. You get an idea how things are done here. And this is the graphical analysis. Actually, that was this year's eye. So I took you through these 5 samples. You might have got a general idea how I has to be written. There are various other samples available online. Your teachers will also give you some samples to mark. You should actually mark or go through a few samples. I am going to share 2 samples from this because other 2 samples are quite sensitive. I can't share it now. I can share you after a month. I can share 3 samples. So I'll give you a drive link. There are various graphing tools available online. Each of these tools are free. Now Logger Pro, you can buy it, but a demo version can be used for experiment. 30 days are enough, 30 days trial to use Logger Pro. Now Tracker is very good for video analysis. Even Logger Pro is. So Logger Pro and Tracker are the softwares which you can study on your own, or I can take you through this, or your teachers can take you through this, and you can do analysis using this. Even your GDC, you can connect it to your computer, you can import the data and you can work on that. So let me take you through a Logger Pro. I'll just simply, how much time I have? Oh. So see, this is a video analysis which I am trying to show you right now. So this has already been done. One second, let me import it again, open. So if you download Logger Pro, many things are preloaded. So if you go in sample movies and you do this, So you get things, you can actually see what these people are doing. Now see, you have to always start from here. I'll zoom this so that you can see. Now this video was taken from YouTube, or student might have himself taken a reading. Means a video has been shot from a proper angle. And then you set certain parameters on this software, import your videos, and it automatically traces this part. Now this looks simple, but you have to spend some time tracing this particular thing. You trace the video. So video analysis, there are many videos available online, how to do video analysis and everything. Even if you want to learn, you can go to help section. I learned it from here and then I explored YouTube. So I am very much pro right now with video analysis. So you can go to Logger Pro Help, learn video analysis. They'll guide you very nicely how to set origin, how to trace point and everything. Right now we have less time, otherwise I would have shown you. Now we go to open. Then there are various samples, experiment sample movies available, and bio and chemistry samples loaded. So see, plant phototropism, photosynthesis, rate of reaction, sound waves and bits. So you can just go through Logger Pro and you can find many other experiments. You can always improvise and modify this thing. So think how you are going to use Logger Pro in your experiment. Even when you are drawing graphs, Logger Pro helps because it auto scales everything. So I personally prefer Logger Pro, and my students also use Logger Pro. Now, when it comes to uncertainties and errors, I'm going to share two resources with you. And I want you to go through those resources. So one is this, how to do error analysis. Miss Archana, do we have time or?
Talk to these people. Students, I just want you to know, to let me know if you're okay with him extending to the uncertainties and measurements. Can you just tell me yes? Because this is very important part of your IA. Okay, so let him continue. Can I ask him to continue? Yes, okay, because this is very important for your analysis, uncertainties and errors. So please pay attention to this part of the, of course, everything was interesting so far, but I would like you to go through this part, okay? Yes, sir, you can continue, sir.
So we can definitely have another session on learning uncertainties and errors, how to actually calculate each and every step. What I am more focusing here is how to present this part, okay? So you can see 1.00, 2.00, and here also decimal places are particularly taken. Now see, if you are using analog instruments, you know least count is the smallest reading that you can take. So if you are using your ruler, your least count is 1 millimeter. So your uncertainty in analog instrument is half of your least count. Okay, so my least count is 1 millimeter, so my uncertainty will be 0.5 mm, which is 0. whatever centimeters. And if I'm using a digital instrument like stopwatch, my uncertainty would be the maximum reading that it is taking. Say for example, if my stopwatch is showing me 0.00, so the smallest reading that I can take is 0.01. So that becomes my uncertainty. So whenever you are using any digital instruments, uncertainty is the smallest reading that you can take in that instrument, the absolute uncertainty. And in analog, it is half of the least count. So if you are using a voltmeter, which is a multimeter, which is analog display, if the smallest reading that you can take is 1 volt, then your least count becomes 0.5 volts. Remember this part. That is how you get these readings. And sometimes if you have evaluated this current using some formula, then you will have to use that formula to arrive at the uncertainties. So to teach that, we'll have to spend one more hour. So we can obviously go through that at some later stage. Now, looking at the uncertainty, I am 100% sure that this is definitely not an analog instrument. This is definitely digital instrument. Or since it is measuring in milliamperes, sometimes we end up thinking, you know, this could be a analog. But see, it is 0.005 milliamperes. So three more zeros will come here. So no analog instrument would give you least count like that. So your voltage and your current in. Now this is this example is not good because see, the significant figures are not maintained properly. It is not good properly presented. Now let me take you. These are how. So if your reading involves taking mean, which is always advised, always take at least 3 trials in your IA and at least 5 or 6 trials in your extended essay. So when you take 3 trials, you are going to take average. So average of these 3 reading would be add these 3 and divide by 3. That would give you the mean average time. But how do you find uncertainties and errors in this? Remember one simple rule: errors never get like whenever you are doing multiplication or addition, errors add up. They never get reduced. So if you are taking an average of 3 readings, your error is going to be more. So I'll just show you what I'm doing. So this is the simple mean reading that you get. Now, what is the range? Maxima minus minima by 2. This is one of the method. So 6.39 is my maximum reading. 6.28 is my smallest reading. And that divided by 2 gave me my uncertainty in that particular reading. So now T plus or minus delta T is this answer, if you want to round it off. So you'll have to show one sample calculation whenever you are doing this particular bit. So make sure you play with uncertainties properly. Make sure you have error bars. If you have a curve nature, you can't have error bars in that curve. So you can explore maxima and minima, but you can definitely show your error bars. Make sure, however small your error bars are, if your error bars are very small to show it in a graph, mention in your report that my error bars are too small. I have included in the software, but it's not visible. So make sure error bars, because error bars is the first vital point that is going to be considered by checking your analysis. So maximum and minimum gradient. So in curve, you will have to draw tangent and find it out. So you can always bring down your answer to the percent form. That is most advisable. Sometimes you know that you were asking for a linear relationship and your graph is not giving you a linear relationship. So in such cases, you can always explore log. If you use log of x axis and log of y axis, you'll get a linear nature. So make sure whenever you are expecting a linear nature and you're not getting proper linear nature, then definitely there is log to be used. Now say, I wanted a straight line passing through origin. Everyone knew as per the rule that there should be a straight line passing through origin. I'm just giving a random example. But what you ended up getting is a straight line going through this point. Now, as an examiner, I know that there is a systematic error in your experiment. One of your instrument is faulty. So even if you see some, you wanted a nature passing through origin, but you're getting the same nature, but going through some other point and getting intercepts, find out the source of error. That is known as evaluation. Why you are not getting what you were supposed to get? That is your evaluation. What are the sources of error? What could have done in a better way? So these samples, I could, so there are many other things, how to process data, my line of best fit, my minimum line, my maximum line. So I would think we can actually spend more time on this, and I'll share notes regarding how to do this particular bit. Because there's a lot of things to do, because I want to give you one more important instruction is what are the main things, main do's and don'ts. So that will take 5 minutes. And these were the chemistry examples that I wanted to show you. So don't worry, I'm going to share everything with you. This is a bio thing. So I'll share things with you. I'm also going to share this link with you and you can just put yourself in this where you belong to. This is a Padlet. So let's directly go to that particular part. Before going to formal presentations. Okay, now listen carefully what I am going to say. I did not get time to import those data here, so I'm going to stop sharing my screen and I'm going to speak something. So kindly just pay attention to what I am talking. I am going to put everything on a Word document and I'm going to share it with you. So right now just listen to what I am saying. I am just stopping the sharing and just try to listen what I'm saying. Okay, whenever you are writing your report, there is no hard and fast rule that you should have a paragraph of personal engagement in the beginning. Nowadays, see your report, let me give you the process of marking. Your report will be read first. Your entire report will be read first so that I get an impression of how you have written your report. Okay. So don't worry if your personal engagement is somewhere within your experiment. Now, if you saw my student of that scuba diving, his personal he was not supposed to write a paragraph of he went to Brazil and everything. He could have directly started his report. I could see many places where I could see curiosity, individual thinking, and his interest. So these are the three parts that you are going to be judged on. How did you make this experiment as your own is the most important part. So remember this thing. Okay, now personal engagement and communication plays a vital role because you know you need more marks. Now if you just randomly built up a story, say for example, you like cycling and therefore you did an experiment on cycle is not a valid thing of doing an experiment because it looks funny. And it is you're not going to get marks for that. So if there are some places wherein you don't have explanation why you're doing something, you just carry out your own experiment. Your own design that you do is your personal curiosity, personal interest is evident on your entire report and not only on that particular paragraph. So this criteria of personal engagement, it is going to check how much you are engaged with your exploration. So even your exploration region is going to tell you how many marks you are going to score. So your personal engagement links with each of the other criteria. So you can, sometimes you address your personal interest, sometimes different attributes like, oh, I designed my experiment in a different way. So you need to give evidence for independent thinking, creativity, or any initiative in the design implementation or presentation of the investigation. Now, how good you present your investigation, that is also making investigation my own. So remember, addressing personal interest is very much important. Why you are doing that topic? So it's okay if you don't have a story. So say I'll give you one more example. I like playing tennis and therefore I want to find the drag coefficient between the ball and the tennis racket. It does not sound authentic, right? It's just for sake of doing, you're doing that. So it's not advisable. There is no compulsory rule that there should be a personal engagement story in the beginning. But if you can actually link it to something, it's always better. Okay. Now, your initiative in the implementation of investigation. So when I'm saying processing of the graph, interpretation of the graph, and how what all things you are doing with the graph is your analysis. Justification for choosing each and everything should be mentioned, even for a particular research, by demonstrating personal significance, interest, or curiosity. So IB clearly states that you do not need a section for, like, you're not supposed to give headings. It's okay if you don't give headings and you generally write a report. Like, I know that I can't give you a heading. My analysis, evaluation, and conclusion all together are one single, one full page. It's okay. But it's better if you can segregate it because it gives you proper breakup of marks. But there are no hard and fast rule to follow certain template. But always listen to your supervisor because they might have a good idea of you and therefore they might be suggesting some things. Now, okay, let me go through that. And an examiner is always going to be marking your IA positively. They are not going to be behind you to see where what are the weakness of your IAs. So make sure you give justification at each and every stages, okay? So give the scientific context for the research question. Your choice of sources of background plays a vital role in your personal engagement. The design of the method, the choice of materials, improvement of the initial methodology to overcome issues. So I had many issues. How did I overcome that issue is an important thing. Okay. So to get this scientific context and everything, just go through AIMS 1. Okay. Now, if you're showing curiosity just by presenting a very undemanding RQ, okay, so whose outcome was very much evident. I'm doing an Ohm's law. I am aware that I'm going to get a straight line passing through a region. and you are doing the same traditional experiment. So in such cases, you are not going to reach the highest band of mark. Okay. So remember what you are doing. Now, there is an experiment setup available in your lab. You are just using that setup directly and getting readings. Sometimes won't get marks, the higher band of the marks. You will definitely get marks, but not the higher band of the marks. Now, whenever you are stating your research question, it should be phrased as a question. That is what we teachers tell you. But it's okay if you not phrase it as a question. There are certain moments wherein you can't get a question. So it's okay even if you make it as a statement. This rule is very hard and fast while doing extended essay. So research question may not be phrased as a question. The only thing which we need is your investigation to be focused and clear so that you get full credit of that. Now, if the independent variable is not measured quantitatively, there are many ways to get a full marks on the basis of quantitative analysis, as I told you in the beginning. Now, don't take two quantities like I have one brand of butter, I have another brand of butter, I'm directly comparing this two brand. See, you're not doing a proper research question. You're not doing a proper investigation, because definitely both the brands are going to use different things. You will arrive at some result which is different. So always when you're dealing with two different quantities, try to have more samples in your investigation. So make sure you don't use two organisms or two brands directly. Now, background relates to only theoretical context. Don't write the story about the scientist or the scientist was like this and everything. Just give a theoretical background of your research question. Make sure everything is related to your research question. Now, you're not supposed to list down the variables, as I told you, independent, dependent, and controlled. Now, sometimes you need large space to make sure your report is written. Now, you have 12 pages, but you have so much of data and analysis and so much of writing to do that you are not able to fit this particular list of variables. It's completely fine, because your methodology will directly show me, also your research question will show me the list of variables. But if you have more space to work with, why not state a list of variables? It becomes more clear. But it is not compulsory to explicitly list all the variables. If you have limited space and you want to save space, you can get rid of this particular part. Now, in IAs, there was this misinformation going on where people used to believe that there should be one independent and one dependent. There is no hard and fast rule like this. There are no prescribed minimum number of values of independent variables. Okay, so because different type of investigation requires different amounts of data. So as I said, pendulum data, I need more and more independent variables. I at least need two independent variables to make a proper judgment of RQ. Repeat your trials. It is very much necessary so that you minimize the error and you have some uncertainties to play with. Do not write list of apparatus, please. People have this tendency of writing list of apparatus. So I overcome that by whenever you are putting an image of your setup diagram, you just draw an arrow and state the apparatus. You are saving space. There is no rule that you should write everything point wise. Now see, there are some experiments wherein you need to repeat the same process three times. So people prefer writing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and in the sixth point they write repeat steps 1 to 5. Now this is fine, but not in all the cases you should write in point wise, because you are wasting your space. Okay, sufficient data should be collected. Now pay attention to safety, ethics, and environmental effect. When there is clearly no issue with safety, ethics, or environmental impact, there may be no need for the statement. So since I have told you that safety and ethics and environment play a vital role, if there are no safety measurements that has to be taken for your experiment, don't mention it. Don't try to bring it some errors that, so one, let me tell you very lame example of my math students. He was doing something in his lab. He said, there was a possibility of earthquake could have happened, and fluctuation in tectonic plates could have altered my readings. So see, this was just, I said I need safety and ethical impacts. Don't state it. If it is relevant, then post it. Otherwise, you don't do it, okay? Safe handling of equipment and chemicals is very much important. the disposal of waste. So chemistry people, if you are, and bio people, if you are using this bacteria or how you are going to dispose it, see, your experiment is answered. You have done all investigation, but what are you doing with those things? How are you disposing those particular things? So those comes into safety conditions. Now you understand when I say environment, this is how you write answers about environment. So what we do is we give all the remaining stuff to the lab assistant, and there are the disposable measures which are taken. So you understand when it comes to environmental issues, a student would have directly written that, yes, I was wearing gloves, I was having a safety mask and everything, but what about the environment? What about the other students? What about the students who are coming after you in that class? And sometimes sustainable consumption of materials also play a vital role. So if you can link your IA to sustainable goals, it well and fine. Now, raw data is very much important. The requirement of qualitative data is wherever, see, quantitative data is compulsory. Qualitative data, when I say qualitative data, means don't just keep on getting any quantity of data just for the sake of showing a big data table. Your data should be qualitative as well. So you could have taken 3 trials, but you ended up taking 8 trials just to show a bigger table. But that is not going to work. We don't want to see how many pages of raw data you are using. Just a sample of your raw data or a snapshot of your raw data is fine. There is no need of putting it in appendix also. No hyperlinks, nothing. We trust you because supervisor is there to see what you have written. So no need of having appendix and everything. If you have lots and lots of data, just put a sample of that particular data. Complete processing of raw data is necessary. Playing with uncertainties, highlighting and presenting your data is known as processing of data. So taking proper average, plotting the graph properly, talking about the nature of relationship, meaningful analysis with respect to maxima and minima lying. Okay. Now, error bars, line of best fit, maxima minima slope. Now, do not blindly accept Excel polynomial. So when you're dealing with spreadsheet, make sure that you are manually putting the error bars. That is why I prefer Logger Pro or other softwares. Excel, you will have to spend a lot of time plotting that error bars. Then maxima minima slope, outlier data. See, this is very much important to talk in analysis. Sometimes you don't have all data in same place. There are outliers. You are ignoring some data. Talk about that. That is going to give you advantage. Now, equation of a line. Sometimes you end up getting an equation of a line. R square value. It's important. Now, see, not all students, talking about last year students who were math studies students, they are not very much aware about how to use R square value. But if I am using Logger Pro, it indirectly gives me R value or R square value in my table. I can talk about that value. So, you know, positive R square value. And so if it is within this band, what does R value mean? Significant figures and decimal places should be consistent. Now, this is part of your analysis. So you're not writing anything, but this is part of your analysis. This will help you score marks. So whatever calculations you are doing, show a sample calculation for each set of data. So if you are doing three different calculations, show a sample of each three of them. Now you can take a picture, you can do it in a notebook, take a picture and just have three pictures side by side, it's fine. They'll allow it. How you're dealing with errors, how you minimize errors. So statistical analysis, sometimes people use standard deviation. Other thing, you're not expected to do all of the things that I have said. Sometimes some experiment won't have any maximum minima line. So be open-minded in this particular part. And when it comes to evaluation, your data should make sense, that your data is leading to a proper conclusion. That is what I need. If the process data does not give you clear pattern, it's okay. You are going to get rewarded for your experimentation. Or you're not doing a research level project. Even research level project, they write down the justification that I did not get this particular reading. So do not go back and do all the data. So if I'm doing one set of data and I find some fault, yes, I have to redo something. But if you have already collected data and while plotting the graph, you realize, oh, this could have been done like this, just write a line in your report. Don't go back and do entire experiment again. You're not expected to do that. If you even mention report, I went back and did this thing again, then it is wasting of your own time. Okay, so remember this. do not overload your graph with unnecessary information. Okay, so simple basic things like inversely proportional, linearly proportional, exponential, those all things are fine. So there should be a statement in conclusion directly related to your RQ. So whatever your result is, you would have stated some hypothesis or research question. You have to answer that. Say, for example, this scuba diving student wanted to explore what is the difference or in the focal length as compared to Brazil water and India's water. That is what triggered the thing. So he wrote a statement that as we go deeper and the salinity level affects the focal length in this and this particular way. But he is also supposed to write what is the difference in Brazil and India that he observed, because this is how he started. So he'll have to justify the questions that he had in mind while doing this IA. So see, this is the part of your evaluation. So whatever scientific context you are giving, use proper literature. Make sure the sources that you are using is proper. Write strengths, and so you do sort of SWOT analysis for your. This is a new thing one of the students did in May 2020. He did a SWOT analysis for his IA. He didn't say threats to any experiment. He said, this is wrong, but I'm doing a SWOT analysis. So that always answers your evaluation. So random errors, systematic errors, and this kind of things. So do your research. So style of presentation is very important. Use headings, subheadings, diagram, images to enhance interpretation. Show your examiner what you had done. So see, if I'm just saying that I created a dark room, it is not going to help me. You need to just give an evidence of how a dark room was created and everything. So there are lots and lots more things to go. So I'll skip to the main format right now, and I'll share this write-up with you so that I don't take much of your time, because your time is also valuable. And sorry for taking a lot of time. I don't like to rush through things sometimes. Okay, so my screen is visible, I'll assume that. So few tips as I shared. Now, this is the general trend that I have come across, that people have RQ in the beginning, they write background information, they state list of variable, then they have set up images and diagrams, then methodology, how they have designed the experiment, how the experiment is going to be conducted, the results, analysis, conclusion, evaluation, and citation. So this is a general trend which is given. No need of writing. I'm going to share this with you. And this is the detailed format that I would say you should keep in mind. So a title or an RQ. RQ is sufficient. No need of having title. Why I'm saying title is, sometimes my research question would not be in a format of question. A title is acceptable. Background information for justification of RQ. Risk and safety assessments. Planning and design is important. Choice of variables, hypothesis. Do a pilot test here. See, can you do something small? So one of the chemistry students was doing acid rain experiment. So we wanted to see the solution which we created. Is that solution going to work, the sulfur dioxide or sulfur solution? So this was being discussed in our science meeting. So I gave a very good idea that why are you not testing this thing on egg shells? So you do an experiment on egg shells. So basically that girl's father is a temple architect. So they deal with marble. So she wanted to see how the structure of temples get degraded due to acid rain. So it's basic that you are going to test the solution on marbles. So before going to marbles, let's see whether this solution is going to be effective or not. Different concentration of solution. So we use egg shells and we kept them in this different solution. And after 2 or 3 hours, we saw that. And yes, it definitely gave you some hypothesis. So that was a good part of exploration and personal engagement, curiosity that gives you extra mark. And this is the evaluation that I have written. And this is the format. Make sure you set your page to A4 size. Use narrow borders. Always have borders. What all IAs you saw, they had a clear border. It gives a good look to your IA, okay? So have a page border. It's okay if you have a narrow, thick border. It looks good. In your header, use header for research questions so that examiner at each and every page can read your research question. This is new thing which I started with my students, and it is working effectively, because as an examiner, I don't have to go back, scroll down to the first page and come here. I get disoriented. So I'm giving a very good presentation so that I score good marks. Orientation should be portrait, single line spacing in IA, double line spacing in EE, extended essay. So single line spacing in IAs, Arial 11 or Times New Roman 12. Remember this. And in the footer, you can write your physics HL investigation and page number. And on the right hand side, you can say May 2020 or May 2021. And citation MLA or whatever format your school uses. So make sure these are the general presentation things that you do. Make sure you have data table properly presented with proper significant figures and everything. But this, if you keep this thing in mind, you're going to get almost full marks in communication. So I missed out one thing, that diagrams and setup diagram should be there in this. Oh, it's here. So label setup diagram, list of variables if you have sufficient page, describe those variables if you have space, give justification for design, choice of apparatus, like why did I choose LogerPro? You can say my school uses LogerPro sensors, so I'm using that, or I find LogerPro very much interesting, spreadsheet, whatever you are using, just mention this all stuff. Make sure you do not exceed 12 pages, it straight away takes away one mark from your communication. Okay, and there are great descriptors available. So this is what we are going, I am as an examiner going to look. Displays a comprehensive subject knowledge, command of concepts and principle, construct detailed explanation of complex phenomena. Look, if you get a grade 7 in any of the science, this is what we are going to judge you on. So you can also write your IA based on this. So you know what they are going to look for. And I'm going to, so there are assessment criteria which your teachers can take you through how each and every criteria looks. So they are subject specific. So thank you. You can tell me whatever doubts you have. And sorry for exceeding your time.
No, that's fine, sir. Thank you so much. It was very helpful. Students, if you have any questions you want to ask, sir, and please unmute and ask your question, and sir will be able to answer. And then mute yourself so that the second student, whoever wants to go for it. Any questions? You can even type your questions in your chat box. You can post your questions there. Sir will be able to see it. Any questions?
It's okay. Even if you come up to a question later on, it's fine. It's too much to take in. Usually we present this IA session in our class. So once we have this general session, and this individual things we do it in classes. So I know it's too much to handle right now.
Okay, I know. I have certain questions.
To all the students, I would like their inputs. So some sort of feedback.
Can you at least give?
Miss, you have muted yourself.
Can you at least give me a feedback on this session? Sir wants to have a feedback from you. And if you would like something, something that would help you future, and if you want him to take another session on certain aspect which he has rushed. I know there was biology and chemistry. I was mostly interested in biology, but sir had to move to physics and mathematics. But no, yes.
Bio examples. I have so many bio examples right now to show. But as I said, if I keep showing samples, then I won't get time. So I chose topics which can be done in chemistry and bio also.
Okay. So yes, if you can give me your feedback, or just write to me, just post your feedbacks on the chat box. Okay, that's nice. Thank you. Any questions, like, small questions, any doubts? Good. Thank you, sir. I think that was very good. I mean, I like the first example that you shared. The guy was very interesting. I mean, the beauty.
Oh.
In biology also, we are trying to do facial recognition and identity. So I think that was a very interesting concept with
so
app.
I'll give you one example of bio right now. So I wanted to do this, but nobody did. So you have different shapes of leaves. So I don't know which category they come in. So herbal plants, say for neem, tulsi, and this all things. So there was something I forgot, I'll get back to you. So I take picture of that particular leaves and I do photo analysis of these leaves to study and the nature of, I'll just get back to you. It's very interesting.
Okay. Yeah, I think we'll do only with, I think I'll just come back with biology and chemistry students next time. And this was all together, right? So I'll just make sure only biology and chemistry students are there.
Criteria and writing of the report was very much.
Yes.
And they get an idea of how our IA is going to look. Even chemistry and bio students now can do
IAs. Yeah. Okay, thank you so much. If there is any more, so if you have any questions, how can we ask sir our questions? Okay, you can, you know, I've shared his email addresses with you, your email address. Sir's email address is in that, remember the link that I sent you. Sir's email address is there. But if you want, I will share that email address and then you can directly ask him questions. So they want to contact you. Will you be okay
to answer? No problem. Yes. Just mention that you are from DRS. Otherwise,
yes, that should be. Yeah, that's his thing. That's his ID.
That's the app that I was talking about.
Okay, fine. Sir, I will send you. I will send you the. I will send you sir's email address. But I think I shared his. I shared his LinkedIn profile with you. There it is. See, sir has shared his email address. You can contact him and ask him if you have any questions. I think physics and mathematics will be your concerns, but still, you can ask him any questions. Thank you, sir. If it was school time, I would have given you a bouquet and the good presentation mail. But we will try to send you a thank you and appreciation letter from our school. Thank you so much, and I would like you to come back.
Sure, sure, definitely.
Yeah,
as I said, I like sharing knowledge because I work for students. I am a learner. I am still learning. I also do many courses right now. And I want my students to score more. That's important. And my, as in, the students to score.
Can I ask you one question? As a CAS coordinator, what do you recommend at this time of lockdown?
I am doing online crowdfunding. That's one of the basic things because we have many very unprivileged people in our country who would need food. So each of these students is doing crowdfunding. Plus, we are doing one school crowdfunding. Then we have registered for a UN volunteer program, wherein each of our students as a school have registered for the UN volunteership. And we are writing blogs for people. We are writing we are making videos for the people so people who are in hospitals, they need some kind of enthusiasm. So we create music playlist which will help them. So we are doing such kind of things. And we are also helping welfare of stray dogs, wherein dogs are being ignored. Police people are helping them. So we already work with WSP. Okay. So we do something for dogs and everything. And there are many other things. So if you have any queries, just let me know. I'll give you many other ideas and resources to take CAS forward.
Okay. I think we need to do a CAS session separately. And when I'll try to fix that. Because the lockdown, and I think, I don't know how long this is going to continue. I think, what is the Padlet link for? Somebody has a question.
You can tag yourself in your location. It's just a Padlet that I am maintaining in this lockdown period to see where people are coming closer. So I am doing a research, a CAS research with IB. I'm going to present my work in one of the future IB conference. Then I'm going to say during lockdown period, how people came closer and how people are coming and talking to each other. So the good part of the lockdown, not the worst. Everyone is talking about the worst. Let's talk about the good. So even if you remember all the webinars that I'm taking, I'm asking people to tag themselves. And it's a good thing. So it will be a part of research. So no information will be shared. So don't worry about that.
Yeah, exactly. I did that. You know how I got into contact? I did the workshop with him, and that's how I figured out sir is very good at this, and I invited him. So yes, do that. It's a very interesting app. Sir, thank you once again. And I'll probably take their feedback and get back to you. I will do an evaluation sheet and I'll send it across. And also if they need any other future conversations with you, I will also let you know, and then we'll meet again. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Ms. Arjuna. See you.
Yes, sir.
Bye. Bye.
Now you can all leave, and please, I'll send out an evaluation form. Please fill it, and then we'll give it to sir. Yes, in a good letter and format from DRS. So your evaluation is more important for him. All right. Thank you all for joining. Now you can leave the chat room. Yeah, he's left here.